My name is Miranda Dietrich. I'm a mother whose son was murdered over a Facebook argument. I watched my son suffer on the ground in the street, and then I watched him cease all movement. The ambulance came, took him away, and he was officially pronounced dead at 2:11 a.m. on July 1st, 2013. The murderer was arrested, charged with 2 counts of murder, 2 counts of felonious assault, and evidence tampering. The woman that drove with the murderer was not charged with anything. My son and I were in the house eating dinner when the doorbell rang. I answered it, had a conversation with the murderer. Then my son went outside. I closed the door and looked for something to watch on television. A few minutes later, I heard a scream from a woman. I go back outside and my child is laying in the road. The accused brought a hunting knife with him, posted on Facebook his intentions, and then carried them out. I don't understand why he isn't charged with premeditation too. How do you get charged with murder and you only have to post a $10,000 bond? How can you even be considered for house arrest? I thought if a crime is committed, all parties involved are charged. Why would they let anyone walk away? Then I noticed some of the things in the police report are not right. When I brought it up, I was told that we will cross that bridge when we get to it. I understand innocent until proven guilty, but this case should have no other outcome. But I'm afraid. Already I feel cheated that the murderer and I both... sat outside of the courtroom together waiting to see the judge. I feel cheated that the police wrote my statement wrong. I feel cheated that the murderer had the nerve to ask for work privileges while on house arrest. My son is dead in the ground. What can I do? Sit here and go crazy? I want attention brought on this case. The murderer is facing a maximum of 15 years to life. That's it. How is that possible? I'm a single mother now with 3 kids trying to maintain my sanity. I've been let go from my job since this happened. I have references and experience in my field, but can't even focus to go to work. If you've watched this far, then hopefully you may be able to help me. I'm asking for help. Help spreading the word that this accused murderer should have... I'm asking to help spread the word that accused murderer should have a mandatory bail, not just a $10,000 cash or surety. Help with any financial donations so I can possibly get an attorney to look this over. Help to finish paying for my son's headstone. Anything that can be done would be appreciated. I'm not a beggar, and it is so hard to make this video, but I don't know what else to do. The website you can go to donate to is www.youcaring.com/Miranda's Firstborn, MirandasFirstborn. Thank you.
This is for my people who just lost somebody. Your best friend, your baby, your man or your lady. Put your hand way up high. We will never say bye. No, no, no. Mama's, daddy's, sisters, brothers, friends and cousins. This is for my people who lost their grandmothers. Lift your head to the sky. Cause we will never say. Every day. at number one. I wish that you were here to celebrate together. I wish that we could spend the holidays together. I remember when you used to tuck me in at night with a teddy bear you gave me that I held so tight. I thought you were so strong you'd make it through whatever. It's so hard to accept the fact you're gone forever. I never knew I could hurt like this. And every day your life rolls on. I wish I could talk to you for a while. Miss you, but try not to cry. Time goes by. And it's true that you reached a better place. Still I give the world to see your face. And be right here next to you. But it's like you've gone too soon. Not the hardest thing to do.
Stop.